Esta basura, no?
We were working with Nourish International, which is a student group here on campus, and we went to Peru for 6 weeks to build a clean water system. So basically throughout the year we raised money through various ventures. All the money we raised went straight towards the building materials for the actual pipeline and for the reservoir itself.
Peru has a lot of geographic variability, and we were in an area right above the sugarcane valleys, and it was in the Rocky Mountains, like the beginnings of the Andes. It was a really beautiful area.
Moche is the nonprofit organization that we worked with, and Moche is a archaeological organization. Founder Brian Billman figured that, you know, most of these archaeological sites are in areas where people are impoverished or don't have, you know, some of the basic needs. So he started doing these sustainability projects and helping out the cities down there. In return, they've been very open with, you know, helping him out with the archaeological stuff.
I talked to one of the locals and he told me it's been a 25-year battle trying to get some type of water access available to the town of Cerro Blanco. And, you know, these people need the water because a lot of them will go to the canals to get water. No one should be drinking that water, and I don't want to see anyone drinking that water.
We're making holes.
The first thing we needed to do was make the clearing where the reservoir was going to be. So we had to literally dig into the mountain, and that took about 2 to 3 weeks. We had to use pickaxes, shovels. And after we did that, the next step was laying the cement. The last 2 weeks were spent putting the reed bar together and laying the foundation. And we got to the point where we finished the foundation of the reservoir. Just being able to see how happy some of the older men in the community were for actually being able to work on the project and seeing it finally go through was amazing.
I'm an anthropology major, and I have always loved learning about other cultures, and I've always wanted to go see how other people live. So this was a wonderful experience for me. On the weekends sometimes we went to see archaeological sites. There were little forts in the mountains near Cerro Blanco. You could see clearly like walls and like crumbling ruins of old Moche forts. Some of the places we went were Huaca de Luna, Huaca de Sol, and we saw, obviously we saw Machu Picchu, but that was at the end of the trip. That was a big climax. It was an amazing place to go as an anthropologist because there's so much history there. And there's also a lot of problems with archaeology that I got to see. The class I'm in right now, we talk about these issues, and we even talk about Peru and how looting and all these issues affect how archaeologists have to interact with local populations. And it was really awesome to see what I learned in the classroom being implemented.
We did it.
Water.
We are testing the pipes.
I'm an environmental policy and management major. Access to clean water is something my professors had always talked about. It wasn't something I had actually seen firsthand. I didn't really have much experience with the issue. I really didn't know how it was going to impact me until about halfway through and until I came back. But I could say that it has now. I've taken a more interest in international service and issues affecting developing countries. And this summer, I'm actually going to return to Peru.
I really believe in the mission of Nourish International. We work with communities in order to find something that's going to be sustainable and work for them, something that they thought of, something that we can help them with, something that they believe out of their own intuition and hard work is going to work. At Ohio State, there's tons of organizations. I think it's close to 1,000 student organizations. And that's one of the great things about Ohio State is that there's so many people here with, you know, 50,000 students here. You can find a few people to have your interest. And with a mission as great as Nourish International, sustainability projects, international service, helping people, you're going to find tons of people who want to help out not only here but also abroad. So it was very easy for us to find a bunch of members, and now our group is going really strong.